Paz and Escape from Mars is the worst video game I've ever played. I mean, the plot just makes absolutely no sense. How come Marvin the Martian wanted to kidnap Taz to put in a space zoo? Why not Bugs Bunny or Daffy Duck? At least they can talk, instead of just sputter like a retard. What's so interesting about Taz? The fact that he can spin? Wouldn't it have been smarter to kidnap an Earth animal that wouldn't be likely to eat every other animal in the space zoo? And who's coming to the space zoo anyway? I mean, all we saw were the other exotic animals from different planets. There weren't any visitors. Is it all just for Marvin's personal entertainment? And why did Taz get off Mars after the very first level? Shouldn't that have been the end of the game? I mean, how stupid is he? He just walked into a random crate to get off Mars. How did he know where it was going? How did he know it wasn't going to the glue factory? And once Taz got off Mars, that should have been it. Taz escaped from Mars. Objective complete. And what's up with this dog? I mean, why is there a normal looking dog on Mars? Shouldn't it be like a Martian dog? And how come Martians wear those stupid Roman brush thingies on their head? And then, after Taz got away from Mars, for some reason, he went back. After going to a series of wacky locations, many of them on planet Earth where Taz intended to end up, he walked into another random crate and ended up back on Mars. I mean, how does that even happen? Who's delivering these crates anyway? It's almost as if the writers of this game put absolutely no thought into the plot. It's just like a series of random wacky things to happen. And now apparently we're on a level where we can reverse gravity. What the heck was that thing I just killed? Looks like one of those crappy McDonald's Happy Meal toys that I got when I was 6. With suction cups that don't work unless you fucking spit on them. Okay, I can't keep up that gimmick forever. But, yeah, you guys should seriously go watch the Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones reviews on Red Letter Media's YouTube channel. It's pretty much the best thing on YouTube. Man, once I get into the habit of talking like that guy, I just want to keep it up. It's kind of addictive. Alright, I think I understand the point of this place. Like, there are these blue arrows that you can jump into. And they like, it's like your stereotypical platformer level where you can reverse gravity. But you can't just reverse it like up and down, you can reverse it left and right too. It's kind of cool. But you know, all of the points that I made when I was doing the whole Red Letter Media persona thing, well, I'm fucked now, aren't I? All the points I made were perfectly valid. I mean, yeah. But of course, complaining about the plot of a Looney Tunes game is probably pretty stupid. Can I? Oh, I see. I need to smash that thing. Oh, that's kind of cool. Sorry about the audio problems in that last video, by the way. I sounded kind of robotic. Remember, I'm still trying to tweak things to get it perfect. Does that disable all the lasers? Well, good. Oh, I guess it didn't disable all the lasers. Oh. Well, this sucks. How do I disable these lasers? More importantly, how do I flip gravity around again? There's fucking nowhere to go now. I can't jump over onto that box. I don't know what I did, but I fucked myself. I can't jump over this laser. Can I? No. How did I do this? Oh, by the way, the down button now scrolls the screen up, and the up button scrolls the screen down. pretty. Aw, what? How did I get hit by the laser too? Wow, this level kinda sucks. And not only do you change gravity by hitting the arrows, but you can also just change gravity by fucking spinning up a wall. How does that make any sense? This is the most disorienting level in any video game I've ever played. Oh, there I go again. Doing the, serial killer voice. Is that a gun? No, that's just a laser. Oh, fuck, I didn't want to do that. Oh my god. How much more of this fucking level is there? Okay, let's try going down here. This looks promising. Or not. And I just walked right into that laser. Alright, let's see where it lets me continue from. Probably the very beginning of Marvin's house, huh? Yep. That's very true. Alright. Well, let us get back to where we were a second ago through the magic of editing. Okay, guys. I figured I should probably show you what you're supposed to do if you're not a bonehead like me. Remember this part? Well, it turns out that if you go this way, there's like a super secret passageway that has a sandwich that I just destroyed, an extra life, and a bone that you can pick up. Now, I discovered something really annoying about picking items up like this, and the annoying thing is that Taz has a tendency to just randomly drop stuff for no reason. Like, you could be carrying the bone, and you could be on your way in the correct direction, and you could jump somewhere and discover that Taz just randomly dropped the bone. For no reason. I mean, there he dropped it because he got hit. But sometimes he just randomly drops it. But yeah. Now it's just a simple matter of continuing along in this general direction, and once we give the dog the bone, then all will be good. Oh, and by the way, the continues do respawn, as well as the extra lives. So you can keep dying there, or here, and keep going back to pick up that extra life. It is a pretty handy feature, in an otherwise pretty challenging game. Alright, we gotta line ourselves up. Of course Taz isn't going to randomly drop the bone now that I bitched about it. He'd rather make me look like a crazy person. Alright, come on Taz. Let me use your head. Alright, now we want to eat this ham. Oh yeah, you can't eat stuff while you're carrying things either. So, eat the ham. See, let's destroy this. Because it's going to get in our way. Pick up the bone. Okay, we want to give this bone to this dog, like that, and off we go. So yeah, how about this technology, huh? I can do awesome stuff like pausing the recording in the middle of making a video, which is pretty impressive, and when I actually go to compress it, it only takes me 4 minutes instead of 20. God, it's doing that thing where it like speeds up to like twice the frames per second or something. I don't know, it's weird. Alright, let's see if I can prevent myself from getting turned into a pile of Taz dust. It does seriously look like a toy that you would get like in a McDonald's Happy Meal or something. Like one of those wheels with all the suction cups. Alright, cool. This looks promising. Alright. Okay, we need to destroy these laser generators. And there's probably going to be a bunch of them. Because they're color-coded. So, once you destroy the yellow one, then the yellow lasers stop. And so on, and so on, etc. Alright. Doing a little better, it feels like. I don't know. Still not exactly sure where I'm going. I wish I could scroll the screen that-a-way to determine if going this way would be feasible, but it doesn't look like it. Well, I guess I could do this. God, those things take a lot of hits. And jump into the laser. Good job, Taz. Alright, can't go back up, so let's kill this thing. Come down here. Oh! Look at that. It's the first of many laser generators. That takes out the yellow ones. Alright, now we only have red and blue to go, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. Whoa. Let's jump into that. And that doesn't really help us that much. What a shock. Alright. I should probably cut it right about here. I'm Duke of the Bump, and I will see you later.